Hey guys, Spirit of the Law here. The April patch hasn't come out yet, but currently there's a public beta version for anyone who wants to preview the upcoming changes. Now, I looked around for an official list of what's new, and I couldn't find anything. That's a little confusing to me, as I'm not sure how players are supposed to give early feedback on balance changes to the devs if we don't know what the changes we're supposed to be testing even are. I think the lack of communication there might partly explain why the lobby is pretty quiet, to say the least. Now that said, looking through the tech tree, it's possible to work out most or all of the changes, and in this video, I want to focus on what's coming up for the two newest civilizations, Burgundians and Sicilians. This is the first update they've had besides a quick hotfix, and now that they've been around for about 3 months, they're starting to be figured out. Obviously, the devs might tweak things a bit, so the actual patch could be slightly different, but I expect for the most part, these are what we'll see in the update, coming probably within the next week. So let's check them out. Starting with Burgundians, since release, they've been second last in win rate overall across all civilizations, with only Portuguese doing worse. Burgundians also had the third lowest play rate, so not very popular, but that could also reflect the fact that not everyone bought the expansion. Digging a bit deeper, it seems in long games lasting over 40 minutes, they end up fairly average, but are getting absolutely crushed in short games under 20 minutes, only winning about a third of their games that end in Feudal Age. Their best maps tend to be walled, like Fortress, Hillfort, and Arena, while their worst are fairly open, like Arabia and Serengeti. All of these things together suggest that until now they've been a bit too slow to get going, but are actually okay in the late game. So how are they going to be improved in the upcoming patch? The first change is their access to eco upgrades an age earlier than other civs is now combined with an additional 50% food discount on those techs. A recent 50% discount for Bulgarian siege upgrades has had a really big effect on their win rate, and it seems the devs are trying the same trick on Burgundians. More precisely, that saves 87 food between Double Bit Axe and Horse Collar, 275 food in the upgrades you would normally get in Castle Age, and at least another 525 in Imperial. I think this is an important change that reduces the punishment of going for those techs earlier. There's a pretty noticeable inflation in tech costs with each age, reflecting the size of your growing economy. So while Burgundians had access to eco-techs earlier, it often feels like they're difficult to afford, and that you don't have enough villagers for them to pay back in a reasonable amount of time. In practice, most players seem to be picking them up fairly close to the regular times, maybe getting Castle Age upgrades as they're advancing to Castle Age instead of as soon as they reach it, that sort of thing. To illustrate that point, getting Double Bit Axe in Feudal Age for a normal civilization with 10 Lumberjacks takes around 3 minutes and 20 seconds to pay for itself. For a Burgundian player in Dark Age trying to get Double Bit Axe very early in Dark Age, say with 5 Lumberjacks, that payback time is going to be twice as long. So relative to the size of your economy, it actually is a much larger investment. This change, making the techs cheaper though, means you can afford them early without weakening whatever strategy you're executing, and also means they pay for themselves more quickly. Double Bit Axe for those 5 Burgundian Dark Age Lumberjacks now pays you back in 4 minutes and 15 seconds, which is much closer to the usual time. A drop in cost seems like a good solution to me that targets the right time frame of helping their early game, as well as just making the civilization feel smoother to play, because the payback time of the techs when you get them early is now more in line with what we're used to. Just a quick side note here for Wheelbarrow is that although you're saving 87 food now, the real cost is the 3 villagers you lose in town center work time. So even with this change, Burgundians don't have a good incentive to pick up Wheelbarrow earlier than other civilizations. Another change for the Burgundians was their Castle Age unique tech vineyards went from turning 100% of your food to gold at a 2-to-1 ratio to now just 50%. That's kind of confusing as we're starting to get into halves of halves. Basically, if you have 1,000 food when you complete the tech after paying its 400 food and 300 gold cost, of course, your 1,000 food turns into 500 food and 250 gold. Remember, this is costing 300 gold to do though, so you need quite a bit of food to make this worthwhile. You'd actually need about 2,400 food or more to make this a better choice than selling at the market without guilds, and more than 2,600 to make it better than selling food with guilds, because of course guilds gives you a better deal by selling it directly, and of course all of this was just to break even and essentially get nothing out of the tech. In contrast, before the change, the break-even point was about 1,400 food, so you can see the tech is now much worse from a one-time use perspective. That sounds like a giant nerf, but remember it also lets your farmers generate gold. To balance things out, the rate that your farmers do that has been increased, and the fact that Burgundian farmers were already the best at generating gold, even if you consider faster farming civilizations selling at the market, this is only going to improve that, giving them a permanent advantage in situations that trade isn't an option. And finally, the Flemish Militia's bonus against cavalry was dropped from +12 to +8, and they have a bit less damage against camels as well. My feeling after doing a video on them last month was that the unit felt too much like everything you get from a champion plus a bunch of anti-cavalry bonus damage, making them pretty similar to a halberdier in effectiveness. It seems the devs had a similar idea and are making them a bit less punishing for cavalry civilizations. So going into this, Burgundians had been showing some weakness in the early game, and I think that was successfully addressed with the food discount on eco upgrades. The gold change is debatable about whether it's a nerf or a buff. You get less gold in the one-time use, but more in the long run. The Flemish militia change is fairly small, and I don't think that one will have too much impact. Hopefully this improves the Burgundians' early game, and I doubt we'll see too much impact on the late game, which, as I said, already looks fine from the stats. Moving on to the Sicilians, they also weren't in a great spot. They were the second least played civilization, though their win rate was more around 25th out of the 37 civilizations if you average across all maps. Not great, but also not awful either. Diving deeper into the stats, we see a pretty similar pattern to Burgundians, with some weakness in early games that are ending quickly. Contrast that with Lithuanians, who start with 150 extra food and have a corresponding spike in the early game. So I think this stat does give a proxy for the strength of a civilization's dark and early feudal. Again, this implies to me that Sicilians are losing quickly to very aggressive civilizations and need to be given something to help keep up early on. With Sicilians, you have to be careful though, as their 50% reduction in bonus damage gives them theoretically a pretty good archer or scout rush, and if you give them a solid eco bonus, I think Sicilians could quickly swing the other way and become far too strong. So what changes do we have coming up? The first is the stone cost of their dungeons was reduced from 200 to 175 stone. Now that may not sound like much and still makes them 50 stone more expensive than a regular watchtower, but that's a massive difference, as it means they can now repair dungeons slightly without gathering additional stone. Previously, Sicilians had a weakness to tower rushes, as building even one defensive dungeon meant you couldn't repair it at all, and even if you switched to taking stone, you could lose the first dungeon before building the mining camp and having the first round of stone dropped off. Just this small change alone I think could help their early game in some situations, and of course there's a cumulative savings if you go for a lot of dungeons as well. Another change was to their Castlage unique tech First Crusade. In addition to giving a one-time wave of sergeants, it now also gives your units more conversion resistance. It turns out it's about 50% more resistance than you get from the Teuton team bonus, and gives the exact same effect as the tech Faith. In fact, there's no reason you wouldn't be able to stack all of those on top of each other. Good luck converting their Cavaliers and Siege Onagers. Oh, and that's right, they now get Siege Onagers as well. This is an interesting late game buff for a civilization that really doesn't have many powerful Imperial options, like Paladin or fully upgraded Arbalest. With their Nightline already taking half bonus damage and are now harder to convert, plus Siege Onager in there as well, I'm curious to see how strong this makes their late game. A common pairing with Siege Onager is, of course, Infantry, which actually leads into their next big change, which is a general buff across the board for the Sergeant unique unit. In Feudal Age, their armor was increased by 1 against melee and pierce damage. That means they'll often take an extra 25 to 33% hits, or more depending on upgrades, and notably villagers now do half as much damage to them. It's easy to imagine how useful that could be when you're trying to build forward donjons in Feudal Age. In Castle Age, they went from 60 to 65 HP, and in Imperial Age, the Elite Sergeant's HP increased from 75 to 85. The main drawback of the unit remains its slow movement, but obviously it's a bit more hardy now to make up for that, which should help a lot with building under fire or getting a bit more value out of the First Crusade tech. Keep in mind their Imperial Age armor was already very good compared to a lot of other infantry units, and their HP is now second only to the Elite Teutonic Knight. While they do cost significantly more gold than champions, for example, you can see they are in fact the stronger unit thanks to more HP and armor. They still lose to Japanese faster attacking champions, but remember sergeants take half the anti-infantry bonus damage, 3 less damage from arrows, and can build dungeons, so they're still quite a strong and versatile unit. Overall, I'd say Sicilians got a pretty solid buff. Their early game weakness to tower rushes was addressed, their late game conversion resistance and siege was improved, plus their unique unit is tougher than before in every age. I wouldn't be surprised to see Sicilians end up above average after these changes, though I still think the early game is going to be their weakness. Now browsing through, I saw a couple of other changes to different civilizations, like a nerf to the Inca Tower Rush and Franks having their unique tech swapped, but I'll hold off on diving into those until things are actually finalized and the patch is released. Again, that's probably within the next week if I had to guess. If you want to play the civilizations and test out the balance changes before then, you can jump into the public update preview and give them a spin. That's all for this one though. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.